I persuaded Sony to give me more money than I've ever had before to go shoot the movie. And this is definitely going to be an epic Resident Evil film. That's how it was designed, was to be an epic globe-trotting film. And to that end, you know, the movie starts in Tokyo. We shot in Tokyo. We shot in the snowy wastes of Alaska. Mm-hmm. We shot in Toronto. We shot in Hollywood. We shot in Long Beach in downtown LA. So it's really a globe-trotting film, very epic. And then, of course, has the 3D on top of that. Well, the process for me begins with the script. You know, I think you have to write a 3D movie. You know, okay. You have to write something that works in 3D, that requires 3D. 3D is a very immersive technology. And I think if you have a world that's slightly different that you want to immerse the audience in, work beautifully in Avatar, for example, immersing you in that world of Pandora, then you write a 3D movie. That's the first step. Then you design a set for 3D. You design a set that has a lot of depth. Then you put elements in that set that work well in 3D. For example, rain, smoke, underwater, all of these things that give depth to an image work incredibly well in 3D. A 3D is, it's not just something you suddenly decide in post-production. That's what I don't like about dimensionalization. For me, you have to start right from the very beginning and you make a 3D movie. Then you also light a 3D movie. 3D movies require more light than a traditional 2D movie. I know a lot of complaints about sometimes when things are dimensionalized, it's become incredibly dark. You know, when we were shooting Resident Evil, we had more lights than I've ever seen on a movie set before. But what that gives you is gives you a very crisp 3D image that you can actually see. So, you know, 3D is a way of life, really. It's not just a button you press and suddenly you're a 3D film. You have to really approach it right from ground zero. For me, this is the biggest and best Resident Evil yet. You know, my idea was for the franchise to make a conceptual jump in the way that T1 went to T2. T2 became a bigger, more epic franchise at that point. I wanted that for the Resident Evil franchise.